down till the sun goes down. When you're gone, I lose faith, I lose everything I have found. Heartstrings, violence, that's what I hear when you're by my side. Ooh. Yeah, that's what I hear when you're by my side.
Ooh. But when you call the music, oh, whoa, 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 whoa.
What's up guys, this is David here and welcome to another Mobile Legend gameplay video. Today we will be featuring Nana, the magical raccoon elf. The website said she's a cat elf, but come on guys, she's definitely a raccoon. Nana was born in the deep magical forest and no one knows where it's at except for Maya, the moon elf. Now when I actually read that on the Mobile Legend website, I was totally blown away. Because who would ever guess Maya is actually an elf? I mean, what's even more interesting is Maya actually taught Nana how to control her magical magics. But Maya has no magic at all. Well, that's not true. She does have a magical bowl that can murder 3 people in one shot. So, let's get into Nana's build. Nana is a support mage who thrills at doing continuous damage and most importantly, continuous crawl control. She's definitely my number one choice for the strongest support mage out there. Her passive Nimble allows her to run faster every time her ability hits a unit, and this stacks twice up to 20% of extra movement speed, and that's a whole lot. This is extremely good for positioning, retreating, or sometimes chasing. Her first ability, Boomerang, is her main harass and utility ability. Because the cooldown on this is so short, now after getting 40% cooldown reduction, you're able to throw this again and again and again immediately every time it goes out and come back. That is just insanely strong with the right item build, which we will get into in a little bit. Her second ability, Morph Spell, is what defines this champion as the best lane support mage. Because you're able to turn someone into a lazy raccoon for 3 seconds because of the movement speed reduction, of course. It has minor damage, but most importantly, and what most Nana players do not know is, her morph spell can cancel any, when I say any, I mean any, ongoing damage effect abilities. For example, Panda's ult, Belmont spin, and so on, which makes her an absolute beast. If Panda jumps on you or your ally, just morph them when Panda uses ult, and his ultimate will be cancelled immediately, even though the animation might still continue. Nana's third ability, or her ult, Dragon Cat, is single-handedly the best crawl control ability in this game. Because with 40% cooldown reduction, you're able to cast this every 17 seconds or so with relatively low mana cost from a long range. You can easily use this to clean huge minion wave, harass enemy champions after using morph, because don't worry guys, you're gonna be able to use it again real soon. With Nana, I always carry Magic Emblem and Purify for the getaways, because you want to be CCing enemy team and not being CC'd, if you know what I mean. Item wise, in my humble but largely correct opinion, Nana's core item build needs to gear towards cooldown reduction and utility. That's why we're going to get Enchanted Talisman and Fleeing Time first before anything else. Now make sure you get your boots before you finish Talisman, because positioning for Nana is the key to play her. You want to be able to mobilize and dodge those skill shots and run away from unwanted engagements, and crowd control the enemy's asses. Now, you cannot do that if you die instantly for lack of movement speed. This will transition into either Arcane Boots or Rapid Boots after. Remember, it's after you finish Fleeting Time. Because early damaging boots on Nana is just totally useless, because she's a utility mage, not a nuke mage. Now after the 3 items, we'll go to the 2 best item combos, Frost and Flame of Fury. These two are the next two core items on Nana. Because of your first ability, you're able to slow down their entire enemy line like crazy, at the same time do loads and loads of damage, thanks to the Flame of Fury. This will certainly guarantee that the enemy do not get away or cannot chase you or a teammate if they intended. Now last item, I like to get Budwings personally for the ability damage mega boost, as well as some extra HP just in case we got flanked on. Now let's get into her gameplay. Starting off, I like to get two magic necklaces first, which will turn to talisman and frost later. But this will give us noticeable mana regen to harass in lane. While in lane, you want to constantly throw your boomerang to harass your enemies whenever they go for the last hit, and use your second ability if you see them getting close to the creep to last hit, and so you can stop them from doing that, at the same time throw some more boomerang in there for the extra harass. And it will not take long before enemy gets really annoyed mentally and start hating this game. When you hit level 4, try using your ultimate to initiate a fight for a teammate. If you cannot find the right opportunity in lane, leave the lane and gank other lanes instead. Nana's not a great tower seeder like any other mages, but she thrills at teamfight, so make sure you're constantly creating opportunities for yourself. A note here is, Nana is not a great solo killer. She does not have any burst at all, especially early on. Late game, you might be able to take out half of the enemy's AD carry's HP just by using her ult, but early game, I do not recommend going mid lane. If you do go mid lane, your goal is still to get to level 4 as fast as you can and set up ganks for other lanes. Throughout the entire game, try to team up with at least one other player on the team so you are not alone to be ganked by champions like Natalia, Karina, and so on. Here we see our teammate Bruce Lee hiding in the bush on the right side of the map, where Gord and Lolita has no idea where Bruce Lee actually is. So we quickly use our second skill to CC Gord, because I do not want to do anything to Lolita, it's just pretty pointless at this point. And my teammate Chao winning like a boss and secure the kill for us. As you can see throughout this laning phase, Lolita is actually pretty good counter against Nana because she can actually dodge her boomerang with her shield. But that's true against any champion that with skill shot like this. Here we see our teammate the Monkey King is coming to bottom for a gank. We quickly use our second ability, the Morph Spell, on their Maya and use her ult to get both of them. We're able to kill Lolita here but unable to kill the Maya. But then we use our second ability. As you can see, I was about to use my first ability, but I see no point of using that. So instead, I use my second ability. I cancel the first ability immediately and use the second ability. We're not able to kill Maya, but that was still a really, really good trade for us. Here, the enemy Alpha saw us pushing the tower. He immediately came in, and I think he actually altered our trolling here. We just stay in range and use our second ability, ultimate immediately follow up, and we're able to CC his Alpha so she cannot do anything. And you can see, as Nana, I do not actually use auto attack quite a bit. I try to maintain my distance and just keep on throwing my spells in and out, left and right, up and down. This is one of those things that's really, really annoying for an enemy team. And you never want to put yourself in those dangerous situations just because one or two last hit or auto attack, because it's totally not worth it for Nana. Here we intended to go back, but we saw teamfight was still going on, we quickly use our regeneration and come back to lane and help. Alpha jumping with the ult. I immediately follow up with the ultimate because he's standing in place with that ultimate, and we're able to secure a kill on this Alpha pretty easily with our morph spell, which does minor damage, but sometimes you'll be surprised it can actually give you some kills. The thing about Nana is, it's not about single spell damage, single ability damage. It's about continuous damage that you can apply to enemies. So getting a blue buff is actually quite important because it does give you the early 20% cooldown reduction, which is really, really great, and a 50% reduction on all your ability costs for mana, which is super great for Nana because as you can see, we've been throwing boomerang every chance we have an opportunity to do so. And teamfight break up here, we quickly use our morph for whoever is close to us and use purify here because I was afraid of Alpha. As you can see, the importance of carrying purify on a mage like Nana for those sticky getaway situations. As a long range support mage, you do not want to go back very easily. When I say go back, I mean go back to base or recall to base. You actually want to stick around and try to harass user boomerang if you have the manners to do so, but make sure you maintain your safe distance. Just now you saw us going back, and the only reason for that is because we're out of every single resource that we can use. We use our mana, we use our HP, so we decided to go back there. Here, that was actually a mistake, because you can actually hold your second ability, the morph spell, to morph the person you choose to morph, instead of the one that's closer to you, or the one that's lowest HP by your setting, whatever you have. I choose lowest HP because I do that with almost every single mage. Now, however, in that situation, you're going to hold your second ability so you can actually target the same person your other teammate was targeting. So we made that mistake. Here, enemy Alpha engaged on Layla. I immediately use my second ability, the morph spell, and you follow up with an ult for the knockup, as you can see. And after that, we just keep on throwing boomerang. We see ourselves running out of mana here, so we're about to use our regeneration, because as long as I see there won't be any damage, chicken damage on us, I use regeneration for the mana regen. It won't give you a lot, but still some for you to continue to stay in the team fight. As you can see, we maintain our distance, make sure we're not getting CC or attacked, and just keep on throwing our boomerang left and right, even though we're out of mana. Here we're regenerating a little bit, so as you can see, I'm going to throw boomerang once again, but I see an opportunity to use ult. Unfortunately, because I wasn't close enough and I was super slowed, I'm not able to hit anyone with the ultimate. But still, that's what you want to do with Nana, is to stay close and stay engaged. Thanks to Talisman here, after Belmont kills someone, because we got an assist, we're able to get 20% of the mana back immediately. And because of that, we're able to throw our spell once again. And here we're back to half of mana just because of Talisman. So that's why it's one of the core items, because of cooldown reduction, because of the mana, which you heavily need for the harass. Another note, as I repeated before in this video, is you can use your ultimate just to harass. Don't be shy of failing, don't be shy of just using your ult as a harass, because you will be failing quite a bit in the early games when you first start playing Nana, and you will feel like her ult actually is not that strong because it doesn't do that much damage. But later on, it's actually really, really powerful. And again, the main use of this ultimate is for CC. And because you get 40% cooldown reduction, as you can see, we got fleeting time, we got talisman, I'm able to use this ultimate every 10 seconds, every 17 seconds or so. A tip for playing Mobile Legends is you want to reduce the opportunities or the times that you actually recall home, like I said before. So we just stick around team fight, and sure enough, we're able to pick up a kill on the gourd of the skateboard. Here, we see Maya engage on us. Unfortunately, we missed her ult because I didn't know where she is. So I'm guessing she's going back a little bit because I thought she was afraid of us, but she's actually really courageous and went forward. So we missed that ult there, but it's totally fine. As you can see, we have ult once again. It's just something that you can constantly use. But make sure, another tip with the ult is, after you morph someone with your second ability, position its ult, not by clicking on it, but actually hold it and position it all a little bit behind enemy, so you get a better chance of hitting the champion with your ultimate. As far as your first ability goes, it's actually a great utility spell because every time you hit it with your first ability, you get this great movement speed boost. So I don't just click on it most of the time, unless I'm in lane, just try to push the lane. I actually hold it for a little bit, like 1 second or less than 1 second. And it position this boomerang a little bit ahead of the enemy so you can actually hit it, so you can give this movement speed boost. Here, enemy Yi Thunxing saw we're pretty low, want to engage on us. Unfortunately, he didn't realize the number one support mage in this game with a lot of CCs that only has 45 seconds of cooldown or 1 to 2 seconds of cooldown. So he came in, we quickly used our second ability and all the first ability, and our team just finished him up without him being able to do anything in return. As you can see, I used my ultimate here to clean the lane. We should be able to finish that game just then. But Belmont unfortunately targeted the minion in the rear end, and he didn't do that intentionally. So you saw him expressing his regret in chat just now. Here, teamfight is about to break up again. We quickly try to dodge all those Yizhunxing ults, meteor drops, and we come in with our second ability to morph Yizhunxing, morph the ADC, and use our ultimate. You can see the damage over here. And as you can see, Alpha engage on us. Again, you see the power of carrying Purify on mages like Nana, because we're able to use Purify right away to get out of harm's way and reposition yourself to constantly apply your abilities. As you can see, in this last fight, in a short period amount of time, we're able to use our ultimate, our powerful ultimate, twice. And that's just super, super strong. And with that, that'll be the game for us. GG, well played. Thank you all for watching this gameplay video, and hit the subscribe button if you like the show. Check out more amazing videos and come hang out with us every day during our live stream on Twitch from 6 o'clock p.m. to 9:30 p.m. Central Standard Time using the link listed below. With that, thanks again guys for watching this ranked gameplay, and I'll see you in our next video.